What's up, guys? We're back here in a little backyard project doing some forestry mulching, a little bit of grubbing out of ivy. So let's check this job out. So this is the neighbor we're working for, or this is the customer we're working for. This is neighbor's yard over here. He's supposed to be out to move these cars here pretty soon, but we're gonna take down this little bride for a pair. I say little. Of course, it always looks bigger when you come back and look at it again. But I want to try to clean up this ivy, pull it back as best we can. I could probably just reach up there and snap that thing off is what I'm thinking. With the mini, we're gonna really buggy venture our way this way. This is not poison ivy, this is English ivy here. So they want to get these branches. I see how they're hanging down over the fence here. So I'm gonna get this tree limb back. I got the telescoping pole saw. Get those limb back, cut back. And then that little section of fence right there, they want a just a 6 to 8 foot path so it stops growing all over the fence. I'll probably just take down that whole clump. He owns his property line somewhere up in here. So we can come up in here if we have to, but that is one big old tree right there. Ain't gonna last too much. Well, ivy's doing a number on it for sure, but probably what we're gonna do first is hop on the pole saw and start trimming out this thing, because I won't be able to drive the machine up in here until some of these branches are out of the way. So need to do that first, and then I'm not sure yet, but I think this neighbor wants me to do some work as well. I haven't talked to him, but I've talked to this guy, so. All right, got all the tools here. Everything pretty much ready to go. I got the mini and the skid steer back there on the street ready. I think that bush is coming out, those two, and this one's coming out. I'm just gonna cut them. Once we try to rake up that little mess. Some kind of tree or something like that at some point. But all right, I'm gonna hop to it and start trimming up that big live oak, and or not live oak, water oak in the back.
Well, that's a start. Got it off the fence there, kind of out of the yard. I was trying to be conservative on the tree, but he wanted it off the, you know, you just can't whack a limb off there.
I'm definitely not a trained arborist by any means, but I do know a little bit about it, where to cut and where not to cut. But oh mercy. But yeah, so that definitely looks better.
So I'm gonna get the mini up here and start moving some of this brush. This one I'm gonna grind right through here. I'm gonna take that bush, rip it down, stuff like that. All right, guys, we're getting there. I got this side all cleaned out. I mean, look at the difference there. Found the cable line. It was in a sleeve, so thankfully I didn't mess it up. Just kind of rolled that ivy back up to here, rolled it off the fence. Still need to strip it off right there, but I need to get some of this brush knocked down. Still got to go to the other side, the other corner of the property, which is in line with that fence down there. So gonna start mulching some of this up. I got all this debris from those limbs in that tree to take care of, so I'll work on that.
Mulching is definitely the easy part of this job. It's all the handwork and trim around the fence and setting up and all that kind of stuff. As long as I don't hit anything, like cable box, power box, you know, something like that. This is iliagnus, this green leaf stuff here. I'm gonna just kind of pull it down and mat it down and everything. I really don't want, I'm really afraid stuff's gonna be back here, old swing set or metal or something like that. So just trying to be as safe as I can. Kind of screw it in the same time. Thank you.
So I got this pretty good sized limb right here I need to cut. It's hanging out over the yard. He asked me if I could cut it. Kind of put the bucket up there to help hold it so it doesn't smash the fence. So we'll see how it goes.
This could be a really bad idea. Where's that thing at? There it is. All right. Stay tuned.
Got my cut in it, and it's just a little bit of holding wood right there. So I'm gonna lower it down slowly and try not to get smashed.
Nah, it shouldn't be too bad. But you guys out here, kind of see it right there. Couldn't have been happier. Worked out really well.
All right, guys, GoPro died. Sorry, I missed that last little bit there, finishing this off. But I got the fence trimmed. So I'm gonna go through with the weed eater, trim around the bottom of it, weed eat it. I need to get the blower, blow the machine off real quick. And then we're gonna go ahead and load it up, get that out of there and put the machine on. I won't strap down, just get everything on it, load it. But the customer asked me to trim out the inside of the fence really quick. I don't know if you guys see that. Lovely. Oh, lovely. So, you're welcome, buddy. So I'm gonna blow this off real quick, blow it off, load it up, blow that off, or get that loaded, so. Thank you.
It is hot and humid this morning. It's only the first week in April. And yeah, it's probably, I say hot, it's in the 70s probably. It's noon. And yeah, it's just muggy, nasty out. Ugh. I hope this isn't anything to come, or this is probably what I have looked forward to this summer. So hot, nasty, muggy. All right, let's just double check it real quick, make sure I got everything. Got all strapped down, ready to roll. And I told him we did not plan on doing that on the inside. He asked me, and I said, yeah, I guess I'll do it. I really didn't want to, but that's just what you do sometimes, you know? But I told him, I was like, I'm just gonna weed eat it and push up against the fence. He's like, perfect. So, got this yard all blown out here. Got that all weed-eated out. Yeah, looks good. Think they should be happy. Hopefully the snakes will stay away. And at least they can see them coming now. He couldn't hardly walk around that thing before. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Thanks to my buddy Craig, hooked me up with the job. He usually leaves a comment if I mention him in the video. It's C Miles. So just throw him a comment below if he does comment. So thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. And what is next? Lot clearing, dozer work. Not sure yet. Gotta move some equipment. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Have a good one, y'all.